This video is on the topic of asexual reproduction. Let's start by thinking about what asexual reproduction is. It's a form of reproduction that only involves one parent rather than two, so there's no fertilisation or fusion of gametes, such as a sperm or egg. There is no mixing of genetic information, so the offspring produced are all genetically identical to each other and their parent. They can also be known as clones. Many organisms reproduce asexually. It is common in the plant world, where plants can produce runners, as seen here. Or a cutting can be taken, and the cut part of the plant will produce roots and become a whole new plant. Other organisms include some fungi, bacteria and other parasites, and also some animals such as starfish, aphids, and even some species of shark. For those of you studying the extended syllabus content, there are many advantages of organisms carrying out asexual reproduction. These include that no energy is wasted on trying to find a mate. There is often a rapid reproduction cycle, so it is much faster than sexual reproduction. It often leads to many identical offspring. This is particularly useful in the agricultural world and the production of crops. Other advantages include that the organism can quickly colonize a local area, and also successful and useful traits are passed on to offspring. This, however, can be a disadvantage, as the population has no variation within its genetic information. So if individuals are affected by disease or mutation in their DNA, it is likely to affect the whole population, which could be catastrophic to the species. Examiners will often give some information in an exam question in the form of a diagram or some text. You will need to identify which type of reproduction the information is referring to, so let's take a look at that now. The drawing shows a potato plant producing new tubers, which are actually potatoes. Buds on the stem of the parent plant produce structures called stolons. The new tubers are formed at the ends of the stolons. The tubers can grow into potato plants. Explain which type of reproduction is shown by this potato plant, and you'll be awarded 2 marks. We can see in the image that the tubers are attached to the parent plant by these structures called stolons. We are told that the tubers can grow into new potato plants. All this information tells us that asexual reproduction must be taking place. This is because the tubers are grown from the parent plant. Even though a flower is present, there is no information about pollen or pollination, so there's no sexual reproduction or fertilisation taking place. Be sure to read and take in all the information given in a question like this. Here we can see a second exam-style question. The green aphid lives on rose bushes in the UK in the summer. In spring, aphids that are hatched from eggs are all female. They can produce offspring without male aphids. Name the type of reproduction that these female aphids carry out to produce offspring. Describe how the offspring will compare to the parent aphid, and again, this is for 2 marks. We can see from the information provided that no males are involved, only females. So this tells us that one parent is required, so this must be asexual reproduction. This means that the offspring will all be genetically identical to the parent aphid. In summary, asexual reproduction involves only one parent. The offspring are all genetically identical to each other and their parent. Students studying the extended content are required to know the advantages and disadvantages, which are that no time or energy is wasted in finding a mate or producing gametes. Many identical offspring are produced, so an area can be colonised quickly and easily. The disadvantage is that there is no variation, meaning that any disease or disadvantageous traits can affect the whole population. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.